This walk is not so much about the summits, but thanks to Wainwright's explorations, it is more about the treasures on show via his route. I'm afraid we initially ignore AW's advice in his guide and drive past Trust Gap to leave the car, with permission, at Swindale Head Farm. We then follow the footpath sign to Mosedale via an old cart track to an area known as Dodd Bottom, which is next to the raging Mosedale Beck. We then ascend via Nabs Crag to the rock outcrop summit of Nabs Moor. Dave and I continue our ascent to a large cairn east of the highest point before finally reaching the main summit of Howes at 583 metres. We descend to have a bimble around Mosedale Quarry and take a break in the delightful bothy of Mosedale Cottage. Heading back via flooded paths, we make for the highlight of the walk, the fabulous Forces Falls. Then, reluctantly, we return to Swindale Head Farm and pick up the car. It was a wet day, but we thought this was a real cracker. Enjoy Nabs Moor and Howes. Wonderful green vista to our left, we walk past the ruins of High Swindale Head along a track containing a river, thanks to the weather. This picturesque landscape had it all, a green open valley, a river in full spat with crags and hills as a backdrop. According to Wainwright, the outlying fells are for old-age pensioners and others who can no longer climb the high fells. He obviously didn't climb this when the grass was long, thick and boggy in rain and strong winds. However, as any Lakeland walker will tell you, it's always worth the effort. And we are soon at our first goal of the day, Nabs Crag on Nabs Moor. Well, it didn't take us long to get the summits out of the way on this walk, and it was now time for us to enjoy the gems of this wonderful AW route. Dave and I could have spent all day here, or perhaps forever, as this has to be the original land that time has forgot. Magical place, but it was now time for the highlight of the day. We tried to capture it in video, but with swelling becks, this has to be seen with the naked eye. Forces Falls. In his guide, Wainwright states, the beck tumbles down a rough and rocky ravine in a series of waterfalls and cascades, and the scenery that surrounds it is extremely fine. As always, his description was spot on. Thank you. Dave and I both agree that these falls, perhaps discounting Area Force near Ullswater, are the best we have ever seen in Lakeland. A hidden away, unknown corner, and we agree with AW that it would be ruined if it became more accessible to picnickers. So as he says, keep it under your hat. Those who don't think the outlying fells are worth doing, good call. You stay out there with the crowds. Is fantastic scenery all round and a spectacular end. It doesn't get any better. As they say in certain quarters, lovely. Simply lovely. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and though I'm sure you're gathering that we're not ones for crowds, hopefully one day we'll see you out there. Thanks for watching.